When I read the script, I was shocked how little I knew about it before. You know, why wasn't he on the front cover of the history book when I was at school? I just moved to Hollywood. I was an outsider in Hollywood. And to me, this is a movie about outsiders, about those who are, you know, different, who think outside the norm. And there was something about that story that really struck me. And I was reading a lot of scripts which were action thrillers and superhero movies and all that. And then come this period British movie, and I just became obsessed with it. It felt such an important and beautiful story. And he had such an unsung hero who achieved so much. It's also this great human element of this man who didn't fit in, who was, you know, ahead of his time, outside of his time, and was carrying all his secrets, layers and layers of secrets, how, you know, his sexuality, how he was, you know, as a mathematician, became almost this like spy and super spy in involved with MI6 with all the secrets in it. And it's both on the character level and on the story level, it became something I just needed to do, and I feel very privileged and honored to try and spread, you know, the legacy and the word of Alan Turing. We didn't want to put him in a box. I mean, the whole theme, the whole mission of the whole movie is to celebrate uniqueness, to celebrate individuality, and to put sort of like a label on somebody is sort of like the opposite of what this movie is trying to do. And, you know, it becomes a condition, a disease, something curable, something that should be treated a specific way. He was just unique. He was just, you know, a character that thought in a different way. That is what we wanted to celebrate, and that's what we wanted to tell. I mean, we're aware of the Polish achievement. We wanted to acknowledge that by it's referenced twice in the film. I mean, it's a lot. We can talk about it for an hour, but you know that how the Enigma was, the Polish work was based on the early version of the Enigma, and how that Enigma was changed when the war started and the German army started to use it. So in many ways it was accurate that the work was a foundation, but in many ways it didn't help them at Bletchley so much because the Enigma was so fundamentally changed. So Alan's in many ways had to start over again. He had to start from scratch with the work. But we wanted to acknowledge it, and I think we have done that in the film. It's a little bit like coming home for the movie, in a weird way. I mean, it was shot here in London. It was very important for us to shoot it here and to shoot it as many locations as possible where the things happen. We shot it at Bletchley, we shot it at the school where Alan Turing went to Ashurbourne. And in many ways, it is obviously Norwegian coming in here, and I came in with a lot of respect for the culture and for the story which we're telling. This is an important part of British history, and I wanted to get it right. And I can't wait for tonight. It's a great honor, and it's very thrilling to come here and show the film to the British audience. So it's gonna be a great night.
Can you do a bit of that in Norwegian and I can translate for everybody?
Pardon?
Can you do a bit of that in Norwegian and I'll translate for
everybody? Oh, yeah, exactly. No, I actually have to say I've been so well received. I mean, I was thinking, like, okay, so I got this phenomenal top British talent and everybody said yes to be a part of this, and here comes this Norwegian and it's going to, you know, tell this important story. And I would say it's been... The whole thing has been just such a pleasurable experience, and it's been so well received here. So I'm very thankful.